Hello everyone, today let's talk about acceleration. And it's not as simple as you might think. To begin, you are probably sitting and watching this video. So are you accelerating? Acceleration is defined to be the derivative of velocity, or how velocity is changing with respect to time. Now, this is true that we are not completely at non-accelerating motion. Earth is spinning and orbiting around a star which itself is orbiting the center of the galaxy, which itself is on its course to hit another galaxy. So surely we are not completely at non-accelerating motion. But these effects are approximately negligible and we are not discussing them today. In both classical physics and special relativity, acceleration is the rate of change of velocity. But relative to whom? Like if an apple falls from a tree, relative to the earth, the apple accelerates and falls to the ground. But relative to the apple, the floor accelerates upwards and hits it. So which reference frame is true? Well, the inertial reference frame. In both classical physics and special relativity, the reference frame undergoing no acceleration is the one which decides what had happened. This is the inertial reference frame, and these theories are only valid when applied from an inertial reference frame. And all of the constant velocity reference frame from an inertial reference frame are also inertial. So, from the perspective of an inertial observer, we can say that the apple accelerates and falls to the ground. Or so we thought until Einstein came along with his general theory of relativity, which said it's actually the other way around. General relativity is a refinement of special relativity. General relativity works from both inertial and non-inertial reference frames. And the insights from general relativity are truly mind-bending. For one thing, gravity emerges directly from general relativity, but not as a force, but as an illusion. Gravity is a fictitious force only needed to explain observations from a non-inertial reference frame. The thing that we need to understand is that gravity is not a force. And the concept of inertial and non-inertial reference frames is a little bit different in general relativity. And the key insight of general relativity comes from the equivalence principle. Imagine you are freely floating in space somewhere, not accelerating, far from any gravitational influence. In that situation, you will not feel any force acting on you. The net force on you would be zero. You will feel weightless. You will be an inertial observer. Now just think about it. Is this situation any different from a situation in which you are freely falling in a gravitational field? Well, yes, obviously, a freely falling observer is accelerating due to the gravitational field acting on it and thus is non-inertial, whereas an observer freely floating in space somewhere is clearly not accelerating, thus is inertial. Yes? No. Einstein considered the happiest thought of his life the realization that if someone is freely falling in a gravitational field, he will not feel his own weight, so the net force on him must be zero, and thus he would be an inertial observer. Same as the freely floating observer in space does not feel his own weight is an inertial observer. If a force would have been acting on him, he would not have been feeling weightless. What I mean is that a freely falling observer in a gravitational field is exactly similar to a freely floating observer in space. Any experiment they will do will yield identical results. Just keep this thing in your mind for some moments. Now imagine you are in a room that is accelerating at 9.8 meter per second square. In the upward direction. The physics we'll observe would be exactly similar to the physics we'll observe in a situation in which the room is at rest on the surface of Earth. Every experiment done on any of the players would yield identical results. These two situations are indistinguishable. That means being on the surface of Earth is physically same as accelerating at 1g. So we all being stationary on Earth are accelerating, and thus stationary observers in a gravitational field are non-inertial. Then you might ask, but the free-falling observer is clearly accelerating and we are clearly not accelerating. And that's the catch. Relative to whom? We already discussed that Earth's frame is not inertial. It's the free-falling observer who is the inertial observer. And relative to him, you are clearly accelerating upwards at 9.8 meter per second square. Okay, so why objects appear to fall in a gravitational field? Well, gravity is same as acceleration. So let's look at this problem from an acceleration point of view. Imagine you are in a room that is again accelerating at 1g in the upward direction. Things in that room will appear to fall, and a force can be felt by every object in that room. So a sideways moving object will appear to have taken a curved path from the reference frame of an inside observer. Now, if the inside observer knew about the equivalence principle, he won't attribute the curved trajectory to a continuous force acting on it, since gravity is not a force. The object's trajectory is due to the curved spacetime. The object was initially at constant velocity motion through a straight line, but then it appeared to be accelerating in a curved path. Why? Because the background in which it's moving itself is not flat, but is curved from the reference frame of an inside observer. Gravity is the curvature of spacetime. Objects don't accelerate in a gravitational field. They are always at constant velocity motion through a straight line. But this straight line is not straight in curved spacetime. So the objects appear to have taken a curved or accelerated trajectory when they are moving in a gravitational field, which we call geodesics. So a man in free fall, orbits of moons and planets, is due to them following a straight line path through curved spacetime. Now this massively changes the definition of acceleration in general relativity. And maybe this would be more clear from the accelerating room point of view. When the room starts accelerating, initially every object is in free fall from the inside perspective. And from the outside perspective, no object is accelerating up until the instant it touches the floor of the room. And after that, it starts accelerating with the floor. Similarly, in a gravitational field, objects in free fall aren't accelerating. They are just following their geodesic paths. While when a geodesic path is stopped by a surface, the acceleration begins. A man in free fall appears to be accelerating when it's not. And a stationary observer in a gravitational field appears to be not accelerating when it is. From a non-inertial perspective, acceleration is not the rate of change of velocity, but it's a deviation from its geodesic path. The objects in free fall are following their geodesics, hence they are not accelerating. And a stationary observer in a gravitational field is accelerating because it is stopped to follow its geodesic path. And there are no true or global inertial observers in general relativity. And this can also be understood from a simple example. Imagine there are two apple trees in opposite ends of Earth, and one apple from each tree falls at the same time. Now, according to whatever we discussed till now, both of these apples are inertial. That means they are not accelerating. But now, from the falling apple's perspective, the other apple is not inertial as it accelerates. Same from the other apple's perspective, because Earth clearly can't accelerate to both the apples at the same time. So there are no global inertial observers as well. This is why we say that general relativity reduces to special relativity in small enough regions of space, because special relativity is a theory of inertial reference frame. Or we can also say that in a small enough region of space, spacetime is locally flat or approximately flat, so the effects of general relativity can be negligible. This is why the principle of equivalence we talked about is only locally true. That means it's only true in a small enough region. For example, in an accelerated room, every object will fall directly down. Whereas in the gravity of your object such as Earth, not every object has the same down. In Earth, objects fall to the center point of the Earth. So there are experiments you can do to distinguish between gravity and accelerated motion. But in a small enough region, the principle is very, very close to being true. So, are you accelerating? Yes,